Hello and welcome to this video tutorial on 8 things that you need to know about dynamic array formulas in Excel. So first of all, we need to know how do you write an array formula. So I'm going to use a demonstration with the if function, a very popular Excel function. And in column C here, I simply want to display the words yes or no, depending whether the due date has passed or not. So typically, you would write the if function like this. We would ask if the value of the cell to the left, B2, was less than today's date, and I'll put in the today function to make that side of things relative, comma, then I'm going to display the word yes, comma, otherwise I'll display the word no, and we can run that formula and pull that function to the bottom, and it works absolutely fine. But let's look at the dynamic array formula approach. If I delete those cells, this time when we write the if function, we don't just refer to that single cell. Not just B2, I select the range of cells, B2 to B13. I then test if that is less than the today function. I then put in my yes, and I then put in my no. And this isn't necessarily new to Excel. You've always been able to refer to an array, but previously you'd have to use your Control Shift Enter at the end of it because it's an array formula. We don't have to worry about that anymore. We can reference an array in a normal function like if or left or VLOOKUP, whereas previously we referenced that single cell. If I press Enter on this formula, it spills to the bottom. The bottom being the last cell of the array. And I said B2 to B13, so it stops at 13. When using dynamic array formulas, we need to understand the spill range and the spill error. And with that formula that I just wrote, at the moment I'm in cell C3, which is not the cell that I wrote it in, that was cell C2. And you can see in the formula bar that the formula, I can see it, but it's in grey. It does not reside in that cell. Whereas if I move to the original cell, C2, now it's editable. I can click in there, I can make changes just like I would any formula. But if I escape that, and if I try to change the one in C3, so I click in the formula bar, and I can see there's nothing there. And if I was to enter something like no, then I get this spill error because the formula can't spill into the area because it's blocked by some content. So this is great because you know if anything is interfering with that range, and it will not let anybody edit the formulas in any other cell apart from the original cell that it was written in. Now it's easy to fix. If I delete the thing that's blocking it, it then spills into that array again. And you notice that the spill range has a blue border around it. So it's nice and visual, which is very helpful when you're working on spreadsheets that other people have built. When you're working with dynamic array formulas, you will need to know how to reference that array from other formulas. So for example, in cell E2, I want to know how many are due, so I just want to count how many yeses there are. But I'm not going to count the range C2 to C13, because by entering it that way, it's not dynamic. I want to be able to count this when this list grows or shrinks in size. So in cell E2, I am going to use the count if function, but when it prompts for the range, I'm going to reference the first cell, C2, and then put in a hashtag or a pound sign. And you can see visually with the blue that that references the entire spill range. So I'm saying from C2 to the end of the spill range, the end of the array. And as that array changes dynamically, then so will my COUNTIF function. I can now just finish this off by putting a comma, writing yes in my quotes, close bracket and run it, and I get my answer of 8. Now, a big reason to use dynamic arrays is that they're dynamic. So let's look at adding to what we've done so far. If I added a new delivery ID in row 14, let's say I had 1455, and let me enter a date that's in the past, like the 2nd of March 2020, and it does not dynamically increase in size. It hasn't accepted this new row. And that's because of the way I referenced the array. I said, let's have a look, B2 to B13. That's what I said. I could have selected a larger range and then that would have been included, but I didn't. Now, it's not wrong what I've done, but by taking that approach, I haven't really got that dynamism. So ideally, we would be using tables right now because tables are amazing. And they would work in that way. So let's put this data in a table. So here we are. If I select a cell in that range, Control T to create the table, and I click OK. I'm then going up to the table design tab. I'm changing the style. I want to clear the style, and I'll remove those filters for a moment. So it's now in a table. And let me change the name of the table to dates due. And let's go again. So I'll type my if function in here. Wonderful, the logical test, let me reference the range. Beautiful table reference there. Less than today, comma, yes, comma, no. But oh dear, we have a spill range. Because big thing to note here, guys, you cannot use dynamic array formulas in tables. And that's a big thing. If you use tables as much as I do, it really changes the way that you work. Now, dynamic arrays are brilliant for referencing data in tables, because tables are already dynamic, dynamic arrays are dynamic. It's a wonderful relationship. But you can't put the dynamic arrays in the table. So, if I just select a range in my table, I grab the corner where I can resize it and just exclude column C from it. So now the table is only columns A and B. You can see the answer spilling outside of the range here. Let me just come and delete the data I've got in column C, and let's do it again. If function, reference the table range using that structured reference. Less than today, in goes yes, in goes no. Excellent. So now you can see it spill to the end of the table, which is what we wanted. So it's referencing the table, but it's not within the table. And if I add something at the bottom, 1455, immediately you can see it grow. Because the table is going to grow automatically with the new data. The dynamic array formula is using the table, therefore it grows. Let me finish this off. And wonderful. And then our COUNTIF function, which I've since deleted up here, would also immediately update. Let me just quickly write that one back in. Referencing with the hashtag, the yeses. And now everything's going to be fully dynamic. I can add one more in here. Let's do the 2nd of March again, just to quickly get this going. And you can see it's all updating. Both column C and column E. Fully dynamic. With the dynamic array formulas, we now have 6 new functions. And these functions are really useful. They are sort by, sequence, filter, unique, and rand array. And arguably the cream of the crop is the filter function. That one is incredibly useful. So I'm going to do a quick example of that now with the same data that we were working with previously. It's already in a table, and that table is called deliveries. So rather than displaying the text yes or no, and then being able to filter on that or count on it, with the filter function, we can dynamically produce the list of deliveries that are out of date for us to chase up. So in cell E2, I can begin with the filter function, and the array to filter and to return for me is going to be the entire table. So I'm just going to click the corner of the table here in the top left of it to select the entire table. I can then put in a comma. So what ones to include? Well, that's the ones that are due. So I'm going to reference the due date column and ask if it's less than the today function. There's my criteria, comma, what to do if it's empty? What if nothing is found? I'll just display an empty string. Close bracket and enter, and that has returned all of the due deliveries. Now, I haven't done any formatting here, so we still need to format our cells in the same way that we do already with our formulas. So I can just select that range and apply the formatting. Now, it's quite common to select a few cells more than necessary, because the big thing about using dynamic array formulas is that they're dynamic. But at the moment, my formatting's not dynamic. It stops at row 11. So it's not uncommon to see people going a little bit past their point and formatting in advance, just like you probably already do with the formulas that you write. Now, another big thing to know about these new functions and our dynamic arrays is that we cannot use them directly inside Excel features. So for example, I want a unique drop-down list from the list of countries in column A, where we can see at the moment that I've got 2 from the UK, got 3 from France, but that needs to be unique. And there is a new dynamic array function called unique, which if I just quickly demonstrate in cell C2, I can run the unique function, tell it to use this array, which is already formatted as a table, and I won't worry about the other two questions. I'm just going to close bracket and press enter, and that simply delivers a unique list dynamically. So if another country was to appear in this list, such as India, then it's automatically picked up. I could even take that a step further and throw one of the other new functions around it called sort. And that list is now automatically sorted as well. So even if a new country came in, such as China, not only is it automatically making it unique, it's automatically sorting it, ready for our drop-down list. So let's imagine in column E, we want that drop-down list. Now what we can't do is we can't take a copy of this formula, select my range for my data validation list, come into data validation, choose list, paste it in there, and click OK. It's not going to like those new functions being used in data validation. Now, this is a big shame, because I use formulas in my conditional formatting rules and my data validation rules quite a lot. And you can see plenty of my videos on YouTube doing that. So that's a shame. However, we can reference the list that's been generating column C. So it's not the end of the world, but it's a shame we can't use them directly inside of the Excel features. Just like earlier in this video, I can reference the first one. That's the only one that the formula resides in. Then put in that hashtag or that pound sign to reference the spilled array. So when I click OK, in each of these cells, we have all of the countries. So I have a unique and dynamic drop-down list. When more added to the list, it just picks them up and resorts them. Pretty awesome. It was never that easy before these dynamic array formulas came out. But a big thing to know, you can't use the formulas directly inside Excel features. You can just use them in a cell and then reference that range. The final thing to know about dynamic array formulas is their compatibility between other versions of Excel, such as 2016 and 2019, and those using 365 and having the dynamic arrays. So let's look at some of the formulas we wrote in this video in another version. So this is the if function that we wrote as an array opened in Excel 2016 that doesn't have the dynamic arrays. And you can see in the formula bar that it has the curly braces around the formula indicating that it's an array. So it still works, but it's functioning as an old school array formula would. However, we can also see that in cell E2, the count if function is not working. We have that hash name error because it does not recognize the spilled reference that we did with the hashtag in there. We can also see with the filter function that was written that we have some hash name errors here also, because Excel 2016 is not going to recognize these new dynamic array functions. You can see in the formula bar what it looks like, and the mention of filter up there with the curly braces for the array, but it is not working. So no surprise there that the new functions won't work in other versions. Finally, here we have an array formula written in Excel 2016, but opened in 365, where we have the dynamic arrays. So somebody has written the if function as a normal array formula, but this is how it looks when opened in 365. And it uses that at symbol to indicate implicit intersection, which is always what Excel does, but we never really saw that symbol before, so it may come as a surprise when you start seeing that in formulas in 365. You may recognize that at symbol when writing formulas based on data in tables. So there are some things to bear in mind if you're going to collaborate across different versions of desktop Excel there and you're using dynamic arrays. So 8 things that I think people need to know about dynamic arrays. I hope you found this video useful. Please check out some of our other videos on our YouTube channel and come check us out at computergaga.com.